नित्यानन्दं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वदी साक्षीभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। Nityanandam, I welcome all the viewers and all the Adhikailavasis and all the participants of the Uttamottama Seva to this offering of the Shakti Avishkarana, the offering of the highest space of experience of oneness manifested as powers to Mahasadashiva. Today, being Ganesh Chaturthi, one extraordinary quality of Ganesha is spontaneous completion. Swamiji very beautifully tells that the intense happening of Ganesha just leads to breaking all the obstacles and constantly being in the space of spontaneous completion. Now, in all of our lives, regularly filled with so many decisions to be made or continuous actions that requires, even if you are working at your job outside or your life, there are so many decisions that you have to make. There are many people who decide either for success or failures based on their past. The experiences of past that makes you redefine your future is exactly where many people are stuck now. That is why many people complain that there's nothing new in their life. They already decide that their life is failure if they have failed in the past, or they always decide based on their past how their future is going to be. But Swamiji beautifully tells that when you are in that joy, the creation, see, whenever you are happy, the most happiest person will be the most integrated person. You be serious, you can be so strict with yourself, you can restrict yourself, but end of the day, you'll never experience the joy of living the principles that you are forcing yourself to live. But here, life in Adi Kailash, where every single principle we follow, right from the way we dress or the powers we manifest or the puja that we do, because we know the right reason behind it, the only before effect, after effect, or the only emotion that prevails in us is joy. The joy that fills every moment in us, that brings the fulfillment in every moment of our life. This makes the whole feeling of your life being same, or there's no creativity, all such feelings just simply becomes redundant in our life. Joy is a starting point where constant creation happens. Joy is a space where constantly you go on exploring, constant creativity happens. And today, we have two of the Adi Kailayavasis who are here to share their joy as an experience of entanglement to people. This is a beautiful dimension of breath where one's intense visualization can be transmitted to the other person using one alchemy product called the Krishna Shila. Now, if you see, both of the Adi Kailavasis have the Krishna Shila with them. And the sacred paste, Jnananjana, applied on that. Now, I have two of the participants of today's Uttamottama Seva who are here to get entangled, to experience the space of entanglement. So I have Jennifer and Rumit, the participants of today's Homa, who are going to be blessed with today's experience of entanglement. Ma, are you both able to hear us? Yes. So you both are ready? Alright. See, now what both of you are going to do is, I have both of the Adikailaivasis in front of me. I'll explain to you what they're going to do first. You will be giving any word that you want. Anything you can give. You can give anything that you want. And you can give two words. So I'll be giving one word to each of them. And they will be projecting those words onto the Krishna Shila. And without each other knowing what each other is projecting, just by seeing to the Krishna Shila, they're going to be describing what exactly the other person is going to be projecting. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to be messaging us the two words that you want to project. It can be object, it can be place, it can be an animal, it can be a picture, anything that you want. You can choose anything from the cosmos, anything that you want. Just message two words to us and we will be showing. I'll be writing those words onto a piece of paper and I'll be handing over the piece of both the pieces of paper to each of them. So both of them will not know what is in the other person's paper, and they'll open and see whatever word you tell. They'll be projecting it, and both of them, by entangling, they'll be able to see what exactly is being projected, and they'll be describing it to you. So now you can write and you can message it to us. Yes, so now while they are messaging, I request one of the volunteers to first come and cover their eyes so they absolutely don't know that what is being written. So we are going to be completely covering their eyes, so they are not going to be seeing what you are writing or what you are messaging. Now, after both of them are blindfolded, you can send a message. So once the words are ready, I'll be removing the blindfolds. Yes. Now, Ma Anna, you can get me a writing pad and a pen. So I'll be writing the words for them. So the message that you have sent, I'll be writing that in the paper, in the bits of paper for them to project for each other.
Jesus.
Yes. So now the two words that both of you have sent, I have written in this pieces of paper, and now I'll be asking the volunteer to come and give these two papers to them and then remove their blindfolds. You can give any paper to each one of them. Yes, and now they can remove their blindfolds. Alright, now you both are going to be opening the paper and seeing, and whatever word is given to you, you're going to be projecting that onto the Krishna Shila for each other. So now Mahanitya Mahajayananda is going to be finding what is given for her, and she is going to be finding what is given to you. Yes, ready? Now, as you all watch this, I request everybody to hum the Mahavakya intensely to experience the space of entanglement. Now, as they do, even for both of you, Ma, you will be experiencing that entanglement. The intense entanglement will happen to both of you, and that completion and the healing that needs to happen will automatically happen as they entangle each other. Swamiji actually beautifully defines this entire process of entanglement. When anybody is soaked in the space of feeling connection, the space of oneness with Swamiji, they experience intense joy. When a third eye awakened person experiences that intense joy, the joy is intense enough to light up many people around us by entangling them. So when they add a spark of their joy into the other people, into the other people's third eye, everybody falls in the same space of joy and frequency as them. So that is exactly what is going to be happening now. The science of this power is beautifully described in the Shastras, where Mahasadashiva explains about this power. It is one of the dimensions of breath, and very beautifully Mahasadashiva explains this to Adi Shakti. So now the volunteer is handed over the writing pad to both of them. So they are going to be writing whatever they are seeing in the Krishna Shila onto their writing pads. Now, I'll be chanting the Shastra Pramana. In the Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, Mahasadashiva has beautifully explained about this power of breath. In the 34th Sutra and the 11th Dharana,
Evamekatma Bhavena Samsthithasya Tu Yoginaha Sarvagnyatvam pravarteta vikalparahisyatyatu. Evamekatma bhavena samsthitasya tu yoginaha sarvagnyatvam pravarteta vikalparahitasyatu.
This has a beautiful translation where Mahasadashiva says, within such a yogi who establishes himself in absolute non-dual oneness with Lord Shiva, and who keeps himself free from all sorts of differentiating notions, the exalted superpower of all-knowing Sarvajnyatvam gets unfolded in all its fullness. This powerful cognition is exactly what is manifesting as a power to both of them, as they are seeing what each other is projecting for them in the Krishna Shila. You both can describe any shape, any color, anything, whatever the Krishna Shila is showing, you can go on writing it. The Krishna Shila beholds the extraordinary ability of being able to hold highest energies and being able to show any visualization that we have. When we project it onto the Krishna Shila, it beholds the ability of projecting those, showing those pictures, those visualizations in the highest definitions. And I request all the Adikayalayavasis here to hum the Mahavakya as you all witness this process of entanglement. The Mahavakya is literally like a password to experience the space of instant oneness, just experiencing oneness instantly. The space of oneness with Swamiji happens as an experience immediately when you start humming the Mahavakya. The Mahavakya itself is a chant. I'll be chanting that Mahavakya to you now.
Om Nityananda Mahasadashivoham. Om Nityananda Mahasadashivoham.
And this secret chant, when you start humming it, the frequency that it creates inside your entire system immediately puts you into the space of oneness with Swamiji. Now this chant will be hummed as follows. I request all the Adikailayavasis to hum along the Mahavakya.
Shivoham, Om Nityananda Mahasadashivoham.
So once Ma Shidi and Ma Mahajaya are done, you both can start sharing whatever you saw onto the Krishna Shila.
Nityanandam everyone. So what I was seeing, I was just seeing forms of Swamiji. So this is what I put. Shiva, Swamiji, Guru, Paramahamsa Nityananda, Kailash, Nandi, Shakti, Kali, Cosmos and Universe. Those are the images that kept coming into my Krishna Shila.
Yes, if you're ready, you can share.
I saw quite a few animals through my Krishna Shila. I saw a puppy or a dog. I saw a bird. I also saw a cat and a fish. I also saw Ganesha. I saw big ears actually and a big tummy. I saw Ganesha. I also saw happiness and joy.
All right. Now, Manitya Mahajayananda, can you tell what is a word that was given to you? Yeah, you can tell it in the mic.
Yes, the word that was given to me was Ganapati. So, yes, Ganesha.
And Ma Shidi, can you share what was the word given to you?
Quite interesting. Mahajaya got all the aspects. It was one word, but what she was describing was actually exactly what Shiva and all the words that she said hold, which is love.
All right. So, Ma Mahajaya, you have been seeing Swamiji's form, which is obviously embodiment of love. Anyways, now one thing that I would like to share with you all, something very beautiful here, is Ma Shidi, have you ever met Swamiji before?
Zero.
You have never seen Swamiji physically?
No.
So you have only seen Swamiji on YouTube, right?
Yes.
So you all can see, without seeing Swamiji, okay, what makes you manifest powers?
Being in oneness with Swamiji, and funny, being here and moving into Adi Kailasha, I realized that Swamiji is actually not his physical form, that he's omnipresent, omniscient and omnipotent, and I've actually experienced that by manifesting powers and being in oneness with him.
Now I request Ma Sumit, both of you also can share your experience. What you wrote and gave. Now you all saw Ma Shidi and Ma Nitya Mahajayananda. Both of them have shared whatever appeared to them in the Krishna Shila. And exactly as written, Ma Shidi was able to see Ganesha's form and the large ears and everything as it was written on the paper. Now I request both of you to share. What was your experience throughout?
I had a very intense feeling of connection and feeling in my forehead and throughout my whole head. So, and I felt very focused and calm.
I also had a very intense feeling right around my third eye, and I also had a feeling of very intense joy and love. And I had also visions of Swamiji.
And I kept visions of Ganapati in my mind as well.
Beautiful. So actually I've been thinking of Swamiji and she's been seeing the forms of Swamiji. All right. See, one thing that I would like to tell is, without even meeting Swamiji physically, just the space of oneness that manifests, how beautifully being able to manifest the power instantly and being able to entangle people. Understand the intense breathing space of Swamiji. Swamiji will beautifully tell, in Adi Kailash, Swamiji is always present. And just his presence can make people manifest powers so beautifully. Understand, this is an intense experience. Any ritual, now any homa, anything that you do, until and unless you have this experience of manifesting powers, the space of oneness, any ritual is of no use, because Swamiji beautifully says the ritual is authentic only when you have an experience, a solid experience of entanglement, and this is what both of you beautifully experienced today. And to constantly live in this space, the only way is to manifest Maha Sadashiva and live with him in the Adi Kailash. And I really thank Manitya Mahajayananda and Ma Shidi to beautifully come and share. And Ma Shidi, I am very happy that you have been a beautiful example to people of what oneness means. It need not always be only to see Swamiji, to have some moments with him, but just his remembrance has put you in so much of oneness that you are able to entangle people thousands of miles away and make them experience that space of entanglement as you. So with this, I would like to offer this as our offering from the space of oneness at Swamiji's feet and to Maha Sadashiva. And I thank you all for joining us in this Shakti Avishkarana to experience the space of oneness.